Today we're going to learn about automatic map sharpening using Auto-sharpen in the Phenix GUI. Have a look at this cryo-EM map. We are going to blur and sharpen this map by adjusting the resolution-dependent weighting of the map. As the map is sharpened, the clarity initially improves, but eventually it becomes worse as the connectivity is lost. The numbers in the upper right corner indicate the final B ISO of the map, a measure of its sharpness where lower means sharper. Notice that the map is most interpretable when the B ISO value is about 20 in this case. Phenix AutoSharpen is going to automatically choose the sharpening of the map that leads to the highest level of detail while maintaining the connectivity of the map. This combination is called adjusted surface area because the clarity is highest when the surface area of the contours in the map is highest. In most cases, maximizing adjusted surface area leads to an optimally sharpened map. The required inputs for map sharpening are a map file and the high resolution limit of the map. The map file can be any standard format, such as an MRC map or a CCP4 style map or MTZ file. The map can come from cryo-EM or from X-ray crystallography. The resolution limit is used to reduce the contribution of high resolution noise to the map. For a cryo-EM map, you can use the resolution limit you have identified using half dataset Fourier shell correlations. For an X-ray map, you can use the resolution of your data. Here is the oversharpened rotavirus map that we would like to auto-sharpen. Let's open the Phenix GUI and optimize the sharpening of this map. In the main Phenix GUI, click New Project and then Set Up Tutorial Data. Then under Please Select a Dataset, go down to the cryo-EM datasets and pick the Auto-sharpen map tutorial. Choose a suitable place to put this data and hit OK. Now there will be a new rotavirus auto-sharpening project ready for you to use. To run Auto-sharpen, click on Maps and then scroll down and click on Auto-sharpen Map. This will set up a new Auto-sharpen run. Let's put in a title. We can choose our map file by clicking on Browse, which will take us to the directory where we copied the tutorial data. Select Rotavirus Oversharpened Map and click Open to load the file. Let's set the resolution to 2.6 angstroms. Now we're ready to go. Hit Run, and the Auto-sharpen GUI will try to automatically figure out the optimal sharpening of this map. As the run starts, a new Auto-sharpen tab will appear and the log file is displayed in the Run Status window. Here the log file is telling us about the map that we supplied. Notice the grid and unit cell and make sure these agree with what you expect. Also notice the origin and extent of the map. The origin of cryo-EM maps is not necessarily at 000 and often is instead at the center of the map. Auto-sharpen will write out the sharpened map with the same origin as the input map. Here, Auto-sharpen is identifying the value of the final sharpening parameter B ISO that maximizes the adjusted surface area, which is the combination of map clarity and connectivity. The best value of B ISO is 100, with an adjusted surface area value of 3.9. This corresponds to a sharpening B applied of minus 86. That is, the map is blurred compared to the starting map. At the end of the run, a summary is presented. It lists the final sharpening B applied of minus 86. It lists the file containing the sharpened map as well. If we click on the Open in Coot button, the sharpened map is displayed. The sharpened map is quite nice. It looks very little like the original oversharpened map. However, note that these two maps have exactly the same information in them. It is just that the weighting of Fourier terms at high resolution is different in the two maps. The oversharpened map has large Fourier coefficients at high resolution, and the optimally sharpened map has lower values. In this case, it was necessary to blur the map to optimize it. In other cases, it is necessary to sharpen it. Auto-sharpen can also be used to optimally sharpen a map to best fit a model. In the Auto-sharpen window, you just enter the model. This can sometimes give just a little bit better sharpening than without a model, but it also has just a little bit of bias towards the model. You can also use Auto-sharpen to sharpen locally, with a different value in different parts of the map. To do this, go to All Parameters in the Auto-sharpen window, then click on Map Modification and turn on Local Sharpening. Good luck with automatically sharpening your map. If you have questions or feedback, you are welcome to contact us at help@phenixonline.org or tutorials@phenixonline.org.